The New York Rangers, a team with an extremely bright future and a team who surprised a lot of people in the 2019-20 season. A team with a star-studded lineup with likes of Mika Zibanejad, Artemi Panarin, and Adam Fox. Alexis Lafreniere, a player with high potential and an extremely bright future. A player with the skill set to be the next NHL superstar, and a player who could change a franchise. So how does Alexis Lafreniere fit in New York, and how could he change the New York Rangers? And how long is the time period until they could potentially be in the Stanley Cup Final and winning the Stanley Cup Final? This is a collaboration with my friend Tyler from WardyNHL. Go check him out. He will be coming in about halfway through the video, so make sure that you stick around for that. As I said, Alexis Lafreniere could change any NHL franchise he would go on to. He's a great player, and in New York, a team that has already got elite talent that Alexis would be able to surround himself in as a Ranger, and I think Lafreniere could be the missing piece to the puzzle for the Rangers. He brings a fast, passionate side to the game and the forward group that not even a guy like Panarin would be able to bring. Lafreniere could be a superstar in New York. That team is now nearly out of their rebuild as players like Igor Shishkin start to shine. And with teams like the Pittsburgh Penguins and the Washington Capitals, who appear to be on the decline, the Rangers could have a very good chance of being able to win back the Metropolitan Division. With an already stacked roster offensively, Lafreniere would likely be a third-line player at the start of the season next year. The left wing position is a real strong spot for the Rangers. Panarin, Kreider, and now Alexis Lafreniere. I think Alexis could get a spot on the second line by the end of the season. Lafreniere is joining a team that was in the Stanley Cup Final just 6 years ago, and since the Rangers have added more stars, they have a Hart Trophy nominee in Artemi Panarin and a future star goalie in Igor Shishkin. The Rangers' future is extremely bright, and Lafreniere will bring even more attention to the Rangers in free agency. I predict we see an offseason like we did in 2016 that we saw with the Edmonton Oilers, and the talent following Connor McDavid to Edmonton. I think the Rangers have the potential to have a future super team with a for sure superstar in Lafreniere and in Panarin and Igor Shishkin, and of course with Adam Fox being a real breakout player for the New York Rangers this season. Now here's Tyler from WardyNHL with the chances the Rangers have in the future at winning the Stanley Cup. Tyler, take it away.
Hey Angus, thanks so much for having me on your channel, first of all, especially when it comes to talking about my New York Rangers. But if you don't know me, my name is Tyler, and like Angus, I have my own hockey channel on YouTube at WardyNHL, where I discuss all various things regarding the hockey and the NHL overall. And I'm grateful enough to be friends with Angus for him to have me on. I really appreciate that again. But when it comes to this New York Rangers team, there's so much reason to be excited and really ecstatic about what is next for them going forward. The Rangers, as we know, won that first overall pick in this draft phase two of that draft lottery, in which they will most likely acquire Alexis Lafreniere. This is back-to-back years now where the New York Rangers won the draft lottery last year, gained second overall pick, that leading to Kaapo Kakko, who looks like he's going to have a very promising future with this Rangers club. And then Alexis Lafreniere, who's easily a franchise, if not generational talent, surely is going to help take this team over the hump. If you don't know, the Rangers just a couple years ago in 2017, the second half of their season, gave out a letter to their fan base from management explaining that they are going to change some things up. They were not happy with their performance, so of course they fire Lane Vigneault, their head coach, and they get rid of plenty of guys in that lineup to help build their trade stock, getting assets in return with prospects and picks from having a depleted prospect pool. The Rangers had one of the worst prospect pools just a couple years ago to now having one of the best, and this was a huge part as to why. They did a quick version of a rebuild, if you will, more of a retool, selling off guys like their former captain Ryan McDonagh, Rick Nash, Kevin Hayes, JT Miller, part of that Ryan McDonagh trade, Matt Zuccarello, the list goes on and on. They trade away so many core pieces from their past playoff runs, but now with this roster with our Artemi Panarin, who's been amazing, really deserves the Hart Trophy. If he doesn't get it, I'll be upset, but he did have a fantastic year. Mika Zibanejad, who's a top 10 centerman in the NHL. Chris Kreider, Kaapo Kakko, Pavel Buchnevich, Ryan Strome, if he's still in the lab because his contract is up. I'm not sure, but there's so many pieces to be excited about. Then getting that defense, whether it be the likes of Jacob Trouba, Adam Fox, who's looking like such a poised two-way defenseman, already the best defenseman in that Rangers lineup, and of course Tony DeAngelo, who can really put up the points whether you like him or not, and it'll be interesting to see if the Rangers keep him long term. And then that goaltending situation with Henrik Lundqvist, unfortunately at the end of his career with the Rangers, in my opinion, I don't see how he's back with them for another year. I assume he either retires or they buy him out some way, shape, or form. But Igor Shesterkin, the young rookie Russian phenom, I should say, for the Rangers, looks great. And Alexander Georgiev is a far better than average backup for the Rangers going forward. But this team has so much promise and a prospect pool led by the likes of Nils Lundqvist, who they, of course, drafted a couple years ago later in the first round. And he looks like he's going to be fantastic. A really great offensively minded defenseman currently playing in the SHL, right hand shot. So that makes more of an interesting factor when it comes to that right side of defense that was already stacked offensively for the Rangers. But then you get to other guys like it's Keandre Miller, a great big body two-way forward, two-way defenseman who played forward for the majority of his career, just stopped a 5 to 6 years ago, has really looked amazing, was drafted in the first round as well. And then you, of course, have Vitali Kratsov, who there's a lot of promise behind him too. Of course, drafted by the New York Rangers, 9th overall in the 2018 NHL draft, Russian winner, looks like he has a lot of promise to his game as well. And the list goes on and on. Even with a lot of these rookies blossoming in this Rangers lineup, they're one of the youngest teams in the NHL, and yet they're only getting started. Now bringing Alexis Lafreniere into the mix should surely take them over the hump into having a decent, if not long, playoff run next year. I'm fully confident in this team and this management. There's so much to be excited about, because similar to, say, the Colorado Avalanche, for instance, and some other teams where they already have such a good-looking offensive lineup as it is, but they have great prospect pools to add it up, and the Rangers have done all of that over the past couple years. Huge shout-out to their management and Jeff Gordon, their GM, and their newly crowned president over the past year, and John Zavidson. They're doing a fantastic job, but this Rangers team, expect them to start having deep playoff runs as soon as next season, and you have to be excited if you're a hockey fan or a Ranger fan overall. They're just so exciting to watch. They're explosive, and it's a completely different Ranger team than the NHL has ever seen in the past decade plus, for sure. So this is only the beginning, guys. Hockey fans, Ranger fans, trust me, there's plenty to be excited about. This Ranger team, I can fully see having a Stanley Cup run, if not Stanley Cup victory, in the next 3 to 4 years. You're just going to be that good. And for the first time in their really franchise history, they're drafting a guy at first overall in Alexis Lafreniere that can be their leader throughout the entirety of his career.
I want to thank Tyler for hopping on the channel and coming and discussing the New York Rangers. Go subscribe to him. The link to his channel is in the description. Subscribe here for more content. I'll see you guys all next time. Goodbye.